Everyone, welcome to our coverage of the NBA on 2K Sports. With Hall of Famers Grant Hill and Doris Burke, this is Brian Anderson. Joining us from the sidelines, Ali LaForce. And a chance here to check out some stats for him.
And over the last five games, his field goal percentage has increased. And you can make a case his confidence as well because of this.
Now the starting group for the visitors. And some new faces in new places this year. All right, Grant, how long is it going to take for a new player to fit in?
B.A., it varies from individual to individual. But look, there is an adjustment period every time you're on a new team. There's new dynamics in the locker room, adjusting to the style of play, the coach, the terminology they all use. It's a huge adjustment. It just depends on who the player is, how quickly they're able to adapt. But there is a period of time before they really feel like they're part of that culture and that team.
Down low. And he goes in for the dunk.
He knew exactly where his man was going to be. Outstanding lead pass.
To the wing on the left. Here's Kispert, covered by Smith. Kispert's shot is good.
And setting the tempo with an assertive move. Like, where was the defense on that play?
To me, that's a complete lack of communication on that side of the ball. These guys need to be talking to each other.
That shot, no good. To the wing, right side. Here's the pick. Let's it go from deep. Smith with the rebound. We played just over a minute here in the first. Can't hit the turnaround jumper.
And the shooter had very little space on that attempt.
Right. He stays connected and great timing on the contest.
And the bucket is good.
And you got to defend better than that. I mean, that's a good look for him.
That's not coming with the right mentality. The defender neither closes the space nor challenges the shot. That's frustrating as a coach, boy.
Uses the glass on the layup.
What a terrific play by just a tremendous all-around player. This guy makes it look easy.
Over to the wing. Here in the first quarter, with about 2 minutes gone by. And a miss there on the triple. Gone 2 of 4 so far. Five to shoot.
Listen, that's a shot he can make, but obviously the defense okay letting him shoot it.
Now, if you're just tuning in, we've played about 2.5 minutes here in the first. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So 2 free throws for him coming up.
Hey, if you can't block it, sending him to the line can be the next best thing.
And the free throw is good. Now leading by 1. That one misses, so he goes 1 for 2. Gone 0 for 2 from outside. To the wing, right side. About 3 minutes gone in the first quarter. From the right block. And that's good. Off the glass that time. Wide open, And he connects with a jumper.
Boy, that's as wide open as you're going to get. The defense needs to lock in and be better than that.
Pass to Watson. Here's Kispert. The three ball. Misses another. Just 1 of 4 from the floor.
Not a lot falling for him in this quarter. He's got to stay aggressive, try to break through. See if you can get an easy opportunity.
Now here's Smith. Shot clock at 5. Off the left side of the rim, it swirls in for him.
Now that's a bad shot until it goes through the net.
Gone 3 of 7 so far. They need something good to happen here.
Yeah, they've gone way too long without a score.
It's stolen away. That shot missing. Shooting about 43% since tip-off. Pass to Kispert. With the drive, 2 shots, 2 makes. Off to a good start.
Well, defensively, to me, you've got to do a better job communicating once the screen comes.
Smith outside. Shot from the top of the key. Boy, clanks that one off the back iron and it falls. Gone 4 of 8 and looking in control. To the inside. Pass to Kispert. From 7. Shot blocked. And they're able to recover.
And even from where we're sitting, you could clearly tell it was a foul.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
And he makes the first. And so he makes both from the line. Gone 5 of 9 from the floor. Outside, Hill. For 3. Gets it to go. That makes him 2 for 3 in this game.
He's consistent from out there, especially when you give him that kind of room.
Pass to Kispert. Out to the right wing. Clock at 6. And a nice finish on the layup.
And they may have talked about shot selection coming into this.
Gone 1 for 2 from beyond the arc in this first quarter. From behind the arc. Nails it from beyond the arc. Give him 8 points now.
Back-to-back threes, making their defense work on the perimeter a bit.
Here's Cook. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Ooh, and he took a hard foul on the shot. So he'll head to the line to shoot a pair.
Shooting 2.
And he drops the first. He's off on the second. Got 7 of 11 shots to find the mark.
Well, just a little too physical out there right now. That's already his second foul.
And now let's revisit that exceptional mobile one block.
Impressive. I mean, you can see the mindset he has. When the game is this close, he really brings it at that end of the floor.
Gone 0-for-3 from downtown.
Come get it.
Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
And he gives up some size inside, but makes a great adjustment on the finish.
Well, he's attacking, he's forcing the issue, and that simply stated a terrific play.
Launches a three. Let's take a look at the Western Conference standings now that the new year is upon us. Already they're on the outside looking in. Ninth place in the conference. Back 2.5 games. So it's the home team now. Trailing by 2.
It really should be an interesting one to watch.
You know, right out of the gates, one team gets a lead with the head-to-head advantage, bragging rights, if you will, over the other. And tonight, it starts.
He nails it, and we're tied.
I mean, they've been relentless. Just keep getting shots at the rim.
Gone 2-of-4 from distance to begin this one. Five on the clock. Takes the three. The shot, no good.
And he probably thought he was going to bury that one.
A minute 35 left to play in the first. Knocked away. Gotten 7 of 13 shots to drop. To the left wing. Another miss. Boy, they're in a funk right now. A minute 4 left in the first quarter.
Come on, man. Who got the ball? Hey, yo. Right here.
6 on the shot clock. Here he goes. Let's go with a 3. It's hauled in by Hill. Shooting a solid 50% in the opening quarter. There's 37 seconds left in the first quarter here.
Well, the defense clearly was not interested in guarding him from downtown. They're very fortunate he missed.
Here's Cook. Jacks up a 3. The shot, no good. First quarter wrapping up here, and it's a tie game. Let's take a quick break, and then it's on to the second quarter after this. This has been a fairly close game through the first quarter. We'll see what happens here in the second. And from what we've seen here from the home team, what's your take so far?
Well, coming into tonight, maybe you thought they were going to settle for perimeter jump shots. Nope, that's not the case.
They've certainly made the commitment to pounding the basketball into the painted area, and boy, is it paying dividends.
Here's Kispert, a reliable offensive contributor, putting up almost 14 a game. And the shot's good. They've been keeping things close.
And now have a chance to jump back on top, B.A.
They set the pick. Knocks down the long J. These teams just feeling each other out.
Yeah, I love the spirit out there. Already 6 lead exchanges.
That's tipped. Outside, Hill. Fires from deep. He's in his comfort zone. 2 for 2 to start this one.
A dozen consecutive points off of threes. This defense looks rattled.
Over to the left wing. Here in the second quarter, a little over a minute of play. Checked by Hill. So it's the home team now. 4-point game. Here's Watson. Now quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game.
Both teams are starting to find a rhythm here.
And this is partly what the game has become, right? A matter of dueling 3-point opportunities.
Now approaching 2 minutes of action here in the second. Four on the clock. And confidence is such a huge part of success. So which coaches do you think do the best job instilling that in their players, Grant?
You know, I believe that coaches that are engaged with their players, who understand who their players are, the coaches who've taken the time to know their players, are the ones who can instill the most confidence. Part of it is just understanding who you're dealing with and what that player needs to be successful. Every player is different, and I strongly believe that the good coaches, the great coaches, understand how to connect and get the most out of the players they have.
The great coaches have always been the best psychologists.
Mm-hmm.
Smith outside. Watson with a rebound. Gone 3 of 3 to begin the second. To the right side. Pass to Kispert. Shoots. They get the rebound. Another shot.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
And he can't get the first one. And he can't get the second one to drop either. Coming up empty that time. Going 2 for 2 from outside the arc here in the second quarter. Oh, he's way off from outside.
And you just can't afford to give up that kind of look very often.
Uses the glass to finish the layup. He's got 5. And boy, has this been a competitive matchup thus far.
These teams have swapped leads 7 times already. And we're not even in the second half.
Here in the second quarter, just under 3.5 minutes played. Fires it. That one off the back iron and out.
You gotta love how they've been crashing the boards, fighting hard for every miss.
And the layup is good off the glass.
Defensively, they've got to get more bodies in the paint. That's three straight field goals from below the free throw line.
Outside, Hill. The three. He connects. And now he's 4 for 6 in today's game.
He nailed 2 from distance in the opening period. Now gets this one.
Pass to Watson. With his first shot attempt, Smith with the rebound.
And this is a shot he can definitely make, and the defense not a factor at all. Well, what he lacks in size for a typical center, he makes up for with all that athleticism. Boy, can he elevate.
Hey, yo, right here, right here.
And there's just one foul now away from the penalty.
Now off the inbound. And a strong finish with two hands.
Are you serious? That is some power from a point guard.
Oh, I love backcourt players with some ups.
We know versatility is huge in this game. Just a tremendous job finishing that play. Wow.
Now here's Hill. He picked up 10 in his last game. Three on the clock. And that one's long.
Listen, offensively, they're very comfortable with him taking that shot. It's a good look under very little pressure. He just can't convert.
Pass to Kispert. The three connects from downtown. He's got 9.
And you know, in this quarter, they've really brought up their shooting percentage.
Gone 3 of 4 from outside so far in the second quarter.
Time out.
In terms of global influence, Grant, it's amazing to see how popular the NBA has become all over the world.
NBA, it's incredible how this game has grown and had the influence all over the world, as you said. I mean, I always say the NBA is an amazing global marketing and public relations firm. And to be able to sell and market the talent of the players and teams on a global stage is incredible. Hey, even you and I, we could go anywhere in the world and people are going to know who we are because of our association with the NBA. How about that?
I'll agree with half of that statement. So both teams changing it up here. He's now 1 for 2 with that bucket. So it's the home team now. A tough loss coming against San Antonio in their last game. There's a screen. Six to shoot. Here's the three. Nails it from three. He's got 12.
What an aggressive mindset in this period. He's starting to take over.
Pass to Hill. And there's a whistle. He'll head to the line to shoot 2. On Tuesday, it'll be the Cleveland Cavaliers coming to town. Then on Thursday, they'll start out on the road to play the Rockets in Houston. Falls for him. One falls, so he hits both of them.
You want to contest this guy's shot, but you absolutely don't want to send him to the line. He will make you pay.
Pass to Cook. For three. It's hauled in by Hill. Hill's got his fourth rebound in this one. That makes him 3 for 4. He's looking good.
Getting enough shots in close to play inside out.
Gone 8 of 11 in the second quarter. Pass to Cook. With the teardrop, count the basket. Gone 5 of 10 from beyond the three-point line in this game. Gone 3 of 4 from outside so far in the second quarter. Here's the floater, and it's blocked, but they'll get another chance. Tries again, and that goes out of bounds. They'll keep possession. Sequence there. They just couldn't get it to go. 1:51 left to play in the first half. Inside. Here's Hill. And the ball ends up out of bounds. And they'll keep possession. No, he's made three, missed two now.
Boy, against so little defensive pressure, you have to convert that.
Pass to Cook. 1:25 left in the first half, and it falls. 2 for 3 from the field so far. Gotten 7 shots out of 14 attempts in the second quarter. From deep three-point range. No good. Shooting is around 55% so far. Just 5 on the clock. Second chance effort. It's blocked. To Hill. Shot to end the cold streak. Yeah. 32 seconds left to play in the half. Here's Cook. There's 21 seconds left in the first half. Shot clock at 6. From deep. It's hauled in by Hill. Plenty of space. Second chance shot. Misses the layup.
You know, so much of rebounding is about effort, and no lack of that right there. He had to box out and establish great position.
And the first half comes to an end. We've got a close game going here. They lead by 4. And join us right back here after the break for the start of the second half.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to the 2K Sports Halftime Program. I'm Ernie Johnson alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Taking a look at this home squad, Kenny, give us your take.
Well, it's pretty clear that they want the offense to run through the paint, and it's been a good game plan. When they've got the ball in tight, the points have been coming, and they've been coming frequently. And until the D proves that they can stop it, I'd say keep working in the paint.
And Shaq, let's get your input on the visiting team.
Well, their poor rebounding is really hurting them. It hasn't killed them on the scoreboard yet, but they need to pick it up. This is a game they can win. If they come out hustling in the second half, they can win.
And it's just about time now for the third quarter to get underway.
Second half of basketball is upon us, and we may be in for an exciting finish based on how close of a game we've seen so far. And this game, folks, a close one here in Salt Lake City. But he gets it back. Goes back up. And it's good on the lay-in. Give him 8 points now.
Their strong work ethic has been evident on the glass, really getting after it and being physical.
Smith outside. Just 4 to shoot from 17. A shot that time, not on target. Smith's gone 1 for 3 on the night. To the left side wing. Pass to Kispert. Controls the rebound and the putback.
Hey, they're just getting pushed around inside.
And if you're just joining us, we played just over a minute here in the third. Offensively, it's been a struggle for them.
Yeah, they need to string together some shots to have any kind of chance.
Kispert grabs a miss. Gotten 2 of 4 shots to go since the break. The 3. That's a miss. His 6th miss in 11 tries. Shooting only 40% from the floor in this game. Just over 1.5 minutes have passed in the third quarter. And they're going to count that bucket, and they'll send him to the line. It could be a 3-point play.
Boy, I don't think he'll get a screen assist for that pick, but they get the points, and that's all that matters.
And Grant, playing at Duke, coach said that at first, your humility held you back from dominating and leading like you were capable of doing. He said you crossed
Mind
that bridge in your
Mind
senior year. Do you feel that way?
One shot.
100% B.A. You know, for me, on my path and my journey as a basketball player, I so wanted to fit in and be one of the guys. And what I learned is sometimes you're meant to stand out. In my senior year, I finally got that message, and my game took off to a whole nother level. And I became comfortable with the idea of standing out. Not everybody's meant to follow. Certain people are meant to lead, and that's when it clicked for me.
From outside the arc, they get it back.
Well, they are daring him to miss, and he obliges.
And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take 2 from the free throw line.
Man, the defender really went after him.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first one falls.
Makes one of two, and the second one misses. Gone 0 for 2 from outside here in the third. Takes it inside. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So two free throws for him coming up. First free throw is good. Second free throw, no good. Gone just 1 of 3 in the second half. Well, we're into the third quarter, just over 2.5 minutes played. Driving to the basket. He's off on that one. Got just 2 of 6 in the second half. To the left wing. Here's Watson. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. Clock at 6. They set the pick from the line. That one's wide left. Shooting 41% in this game. Pass to Smith. Down low. Soft touch off the glass. 10 points for him.
Keeping pace here. That's an excellent move inside.
Shooting 46%. A decent average so far. Here's Kispert. Fires the three. Finds it again. 6 for 12 and remaining assertive.
And his fantastic performance from the last game has carried over to tonight.
Now, I think that's the one thing every player is searching for. Consistency. They're giving this guy a chance to carry the offense once again.
There's just a lot of wide open lanes to the rim here. That'll drive your coach nuts.
Well, poor rotations, poor communication. There's a lot to figure out right now.
Watson with a rebound. Gotten just 3 of 8 shots to go in the third quarter. Banks in the layup.
Well, the advantage they have right now is largely based on his play. What an outstanding night.
The floater. Watson with a rebound. Gone just 1 of 3 from deep since the break. Out to the wing. Pass to Kispert from the arc. And no good. Gotten only 2 of 7 shots to go in the third quarter. Things just don't seem to be clicking for them offensively.
Yeah, they really need to find a way to get back on track.
Can't connect from 13 feet out. Gotten only 4 of 10 shots to fall so far in the third. Pass to Watson. Here's Kispert from behind the arc. Ooh, that one makes him 7 for 14. Got a nice rhythm going here today.
And just not letting up at all. I mean, you have to love this approach. You want to get the ball to the guys who make plays.
One thing we've learned in the NBA, the game is never over. So you've got to continue to score, continue to build your lead.
Pass to Watson. Here's Kispert. Fires for 3. That one won't go. That's his 8th miss out of 15 shots. To stop the run. And the layup is up and in.
Soft interior D, and they've exploited it.
Gotten 5 of 12 shots to drop in the third. There's the drive.
Slams it down with 2 hands.
Man, they're really getting aggressive now. Shooting a less than average 27% in the third quarter.
That's a good timeout. They just can't hit anything.
Sometimes it just feels like misses become contagious. He wants to settle his guys down right now.
Target from outside. Gone 6 of 13 to open up this second half. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair. And every year in the draft, we see teams being risk averse, avoiding players with medical red flags. But we've seen teams who took a chance often rewarded Doris.
That's exactly right, B.A. Look no further than Michael Porter Jr. Back issues while he was 1 year in college at Missouri scared away a lot of teams. But here's a young man who on the offensive end and from a rebounding perspective has shown a big-time upside. He is a big-time shot maker, incredible shooter, even under duress of contest. Defensively, he's got to grow. But I'll tell you what, for GMs who are secure in their jobs, they can take a flyer on a talent like Michael Porter Jr., and the opportunity to pay huge dividends is there.
So he gets them both. Shooting just 38%. Their offense not where they want to be. Up top, Hill. Just 5 to shoot. 3-pointer. Doesn't go that time.
And they're up considerably because of their efforts on the glass.
And that one falls. His 5th basket in 7 tries.
And trust me, when the D's slow to react, he'll be the first guy to make them pay.
And that's typical of this guy. He's always reading the situation, reacting quickly, and capitalizing.
No good on the triple. Gotten 7 of 14 attempts to fall in the half. Pass to Kispert. A minute 53 left in the third. From down low, and there's the rejection. And they get it back. And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time. A fantastic mobile one block. This one deserves another look.
That should really give him a jolt. I mean, nothing like a rejection to light a fire under you.
Got nothing to fall from outside in this third quarter. Pass to Hill.
Hey, who got him?
A minute 29 left in the third quarter. To end the drought. Rebounded by Cook. Gone 2 of 6 from downtown here in the second half. To the inside. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
And he just powered through contact trying to complete the play.
Down the first one.
In the second half, their free throw percentage has improved, hitting in the low 80s now.
So he hits 1 of 2 from the stripe. Shooting about 35% so far in this game. Pass to Hill. There's 53 seconds left to play in the third quarter here. It's tipped. Here's Cook. Takes a 13-footer. It's hauled in by Hill. Hill's got rebound number 8 here already in the game. 24 seconds left to play in the third quarter.
Shooting two.
That free throw, no good. He ends up missing both free throws. Gone 2 of 6 from downtown here in the second half. Here's Cook.
Listen, we know the mid-range game is in this guy's arsenal, but you wonder, should he have moved it just one pass more?
Well, through three quarters of play, down double digits, it may be difficult to overcome. Up by 16. And coming up as soon as we return from break, the fourth quarter gets underway. And a worthy candidate tonight as we take a look at our State Farm Assist of the Game.
You know, I'm kind of stoked that this was a choice because I love this pass. A remarkable find. He put his court vision on full display.
Well, making the game easy for your teammates. All about putting them in a position to score. That's pretty.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may already be out of hand. Off with the layup. They're enjoying a sizable lead.
And what I like, B.A., they haven't stopped pressing the issue.
Puts it up from 12. It's hauled in by Hill.
Well, this has not been his finest hour, but give your teammates some credit for doing the job of stepping in.
Hits the trifecta.
His first triple of the second half. That makes three for the game.
To the wing on the left. Checked by Hill. Pass to Watson. Six on the shot clock. Out to the right wing. Three-pointer, no good. Fires the three. Missed it there. He's 4 for 9 now. About a minute and a half into the fourth now. Here's Kispert. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
Oh, what tremendous focus to absorb the contact and find a way there to finish.
So it's both teams making substitutions here. The visitors with the ball. They trail by 16. And there's the drive. And it's all from three-point range.
Man, that's his shot. Maybe he was too wide open.
Goes in as he's fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts the free throw. Visitors with the ball. 19-point game.
They're looking to do something to stop this run. They have to get back on track.
Really needs to settle his guys down right now and get them refocused.
the home team on D. They played a great fourth quarter defensively, allowing only 3 points. Out left to the wing. That three's off the mark. Gone 2 of 5 from the field in this final quarter. To the left wing. Just over 2.5 minutes played now. Final quarter of regulation. Smith with the rebound. Gotten just one of their 4 threes to go here in the fourth quarter. He shoots. And the jumper from the wing offline.
I think this is a spot he has got to become more consistent from. If you want to command the defender's respect.
Here's Kispert. It's hauled in by Hill. Hill's got 10 rebounds here tonight. So active. Pass to Smith. Let's it go from deep. Watson with the rebound.
He started out strong. 3 threes in the first half, but the long ball has disappeared on him since.
To the paint. 13 feet out. Second chance shot, and he lays it up and in.
They're winning the battle down low by imposing their will.
Shooting just around 32% from the field. Pass to Hill. Throws it up high.
Gliding the pass to where it needed to be.
Wow, a strong finish to seal the deal. He takes it in. So it'll be 2 free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting. That one's off.
And after attempting no free throws in the first half, now he's putting the defense back on its heels.
Good on the second one. Boy, what a rookie class we saw in the NBA last season, Grant. Some special talent out there.
Some really promising talent entered the league last season. And I'll tell you, one thing that I've learned through the history is players end up retiring and leaving the game. The league replenishes always with just some incredible talent. We saw Zion Williamson and his athleticism play above the rim. Ja Morant, out of nowhere, emerging just as an incredible future star in this league. Kendrick Nunn and others. So it's safe to say that the league is in good hands and the future is bright for some of these rookies from last season.
Gone 1 for 5 from downtown here in the fourth. Smith outside. Fades. No good off the back of the rim.
After the strong first half, this guy has not been the same, and largely a no-show right here.
Pass to Watson. This one for 3. Nice work on the boards, paying off with a basket.
This run has been fueled by their Matador defense.
They've been having major problems offensively.
Definitely in a bit of a dry spell.
Six to shoot. Counted from distance.
Knocks that one down. 4 triples for the night. 3 in the first half.
And load management, a term that's entered the NBA lexicon in recent years. Obviously good to protect the player's health. But Doris, any concerns about players sitting?
Absolutely, B.A. First of all, you sympathize with the fans who paid for the ticket expecting the star to play and then being disappointed. from the broadcast perspective, obviously your TV partners want the best players on the floor. They're putting the best teams on the air because of the star power. This is a weighty issue for the NBA. If the season is too long and players are too tired, then maybe you need to shorten the season. But you cannot give short shrift to your constituents. Your league is based on fans and engagement. This is something the league has got to deal with.
Can't get it to drop. Gone 0 for 3 here in the fourth. Misses the 3.
Boy, a tough go for him in this quarter. You can see how desperately he wants to get things started. He just can't make a shot.
Now, you have to extend that defense. I mean, you really have to stay connected to him at all times.
Well, you know this. This is a guy who's looking for his shot the whole time. You have to know who you're guarding. KYP, know your personnel.
And now we present our New Balance Player of the Game.
It's almost beyond belief what he's done in this game. He's been impossible to cool off, hitting just about everything he looks at. It doesn't matter who's guarding him. He's had an answer for just about everyone.
Well, they were coming off 2 straight losses, and he put his foot down. He stepped up his game, had a big night, and got them moving in the right direction again. Well, the NBA had a plan in place pretty quickly on how to resume play during the pandemic. Grant, the bubble was a success.
It really was, B.A., and you have to tip your hat to the NBA and its leadership. You know, Adam Silver, Mark Tatum, Kathy Behrens, they were very thoughtful, very deliberate in terms of how to restart the NBA bubble in the midst of this pandemic. And you know what? We didn't have a situation that was a petri dish. We were able to focus on basketball, great play, individual performances, team performances, and ultimately able to crown a champion. So kudos to the NBA for a fantastic job resuming play.
So it's the home team now. They lead by 24, their biggest margin, to the middle. And he makes no mistake, slam dunk.
I just love the strong finish there inside.
Man, he's got that dunker's mindset, doesn't he? Always ready to pounce. The 3 is up. That won't go. Making him 6 for 12 from the floor now. Pass to Kispert. There's 1:34 left to play in the fourth. Shot clock at 6. From deep, sinks the tray. He's got 26.
And they're really rolling right now. That lead keeps getting bigger and bigger.
And one of the things that's helped that is they're getting it done on both ends. Terrific focus on offense, and they're locked in defensively.
Here's the pick. Well, in last season, the first time we saw coaches' challenges that added a layer of replay review. Now, the coaches generally lose their challenges, but Doris, you think it was a success?
Well, regardless, BA, I think this is something that is here to stay. And not only that, the case was made that if the challenge is successful, a team should retain their right to challenge later in the game. I think this is a good idea. That is something I would like to see happen.
1:04 left to play in the fourth quarter. Into the lane. Steps back. And he gets it to go. He's 8 of 11 now.
Finishing the game strong. This is how you shut the door on any hopes of a comeback.
No question. They've gotten hot at exactly the right time. Clutch play on a team level.
Now here's Clark. Right side, Hill. And he's going to the line for two. The official saw contact while he was going up.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first one falls. And good on the second, so he makes them both. 32 seconds left in the fourth. And here's Harris. Going inside. Oh, the teardrop falls in.
Their home crowd has energized them all game. Now they're closing it out.
Well, for all intents and purposes, this game is over. Just a matter of time here.
Goes up from the top of the key. And so the home crowd treated to a win, showing that they're the far superior team. They win it going away.
I'll tell you what, give it up for their fans. They love to watch this team dominate. You best believe they're all going home happy tonight.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Doris Burke, Allie LaForce, and Grant Hill, and all of our crew, this is Brian Anderson thanking you for watching this 2K Sports presentation of the NBA. We'll see you next time.